Welcome to Well Played. I'm your host, Trevor Cooper. As a parental note, these videos may contain some adult language, so if you are a parent, please watch the video first. If you are a younger gamer, please let your parents watch beforehand to make sure that all of the content is suitable. Now, without further ado, this week we are playing Graveyards, Ghosts, and Haunted Houses by Mike Ritchie and Rather Dashing Games. Now, let's go to the table and see Graveyards, Ghosts, and Haunted Houses Well Played. Hello and welcome to Well Played. We are going to be playing Graveyards, Ghosts, and Haunted Houses by Rather Dashing Games today. This is a tile laying game, and essentially we are each playing as ghosts, and we are trying to scare children, avoid paranormal investigators, and possible burials with tombstones. So, we have determined that I will go first. And I am playing as the orange ghost. I'm Trevor, host and resident good guy on this channel. Across from me is Lorenzo, or Lincho for short. He is going to be playing the white ghost. Sitting next to him is Francisco. He will be playing the green ghost. Yep. And then next to me is Daniel, who will be playing the blue ghost. So I'm going to go ahead and go first here. And I think I'm going to start off with a nice little half orange, half blue there. And then draw up. Your turn, sir. Blocking me early. That does allow you to place a token, if you'd like. Remember that the meddling kids...
Okay. Does that go there?
No, it doesn't need to go on the tile that it was played on.
Okay.
You just place it on a... You pick one of your tokens and place it on a tile.
We don't have to match these?
You don't have to, necessarily.
You kind of want to.
But you kind of want to increase your score.
Okay. Yeah, no, I'm only coming from, like, Carcassonne.
Oh, yeah, no, match, no. So. This, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a tile placement, but not Carcassonne.
Okay.
So you can play any tile you like. It could potentially be helpful or harmful. Okay.
The tile.
All right. Well now.
Oh, and you need another tile.
Yep.
Why don't you just put the tile deck and put half right here for...
Yeah, we can do that.
And did you want to rotate anything?
I'm looking. Not really.
Oh, never mind, the tile's locked, so you couldn't do it.
Yeah, he couldn't rotate this one because it's locked.
So I can only rotate something I'm touching, or either one?
You can rotate any tile in play, but if it has a token on it, it is locked.
Okay.
However, rotate will also let you move a token. So you could, say, for example, move it there.
Really? I wasn't doing anything.
But that allows me to do this, which helps both of us. You're welcome. I think I want to go ahead and play that one there, and I am going to rotate this guy. location. Alrighty then. There's also a draw stack there.
Oh!
Just so you know.
I am blind.
That's alright.
Guess I'll put this one there.
Okay. My own balls.
You can say balls, I'll say testicles.
Wow.
Okay.
Was it fair to you that I actually just said testicles?
I think I will play. Yeah. I'll do that. And I'm gonna put a meddling kid right there and lock that one down. Why are you fucking with me? What did I do?
I am going to place that there.
Nice.
Nice. Place this with that.
Is it from your hand or is it from...
It is from your hand.
Okay.
Yep. Cool. And so that makes a contiguous line there.
Nice.
Maybe a good time for you to lock something down with your house on your next turn.
Maybe. We'll see.
Just throw that on my hand.
Okay. I think I'm going to tack this one on over here. And I'm going to replace something. Go ahead and take this one and do that. Okay, and you can place another token out. There you go, some meddling kids. Lock it down. Now, you can. It will lock all three of these.
Mm-hmm.
However, if you put it on those two, you will get the bonus on all four of those ghosts.
But I think he's locking that for continuous.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, that would be my turn.
I could do this and then rotate that one back to a more helpful position for me.
Can I use a turn to just put a token?
No, you have to have a tile that lets you place a token.
Alright. Okay. And I put that.
Very nice.
Does it have to be a line or can I just or does it have to be like connecting, just connecting?
It has to touch flat side to flat side, so it can't be, it couldn't be staggered.
I'm talking about when scoring.
It's like with this one, how his is in a line, but it also adds these ones right here.
Yeah, but I'm talking about flat right here.
Yeah, yeah, that all counts.
As long as it's a continuous connection.
Yeah. Yep, that's all one section right now.
Okay, just making sure.
Yep. Add some more blue.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Well, I don't have a lot of helpful anything. So, I think I'm going to do that.
I would.
I keep getting all of the tiles that Lorenzo needs.
Oh, darn.
Same here.
Got all these white ghosts and nothing to do.
Same here.
Spread them out.
Glare.
There you go.
What happens if there's two meddling kids in here?
Then they're each worth 3 points.
Yep.
You basically, you'll lose the ghost point, but you'll gain the three meddling kids. So essentially, you're going to gain 2 points. Advantageous.
Okay, so I'm going to put that right there.
And you can move that anywhere. Okay, so he does still have a contiguous line there, because the house does count. However, if you were to move it to like there, then it breaks that.
There.
Moves to it.
Just saying.
And it's only these that I get to move?
The rotate, you can either rotate a tile in play, or you can move a token.
But it's only those that get to move tokens.
Yes.
Okay. I thought the place token was also allowing you to move tokens, too.
No, you get to place one that you have. Okay. Swap will let you swap two tokens, okay. And replace will let you pick up a token and place one of your own.
Got it.
I don't know if you get to place one of your own anywhere, or take any one token off a tile and replace it with one of theirs. The player keeps... Yeah. So you would remove it and put one of yours in its place.
Okay.
Okay.
Whose turn is it?
Mine?
Yours. Okay. I need to break up this green party going on over here.
No! My party!
I voted Nader, I hate everyone. Fuck the green party.
I mean, as the orange ghost here, does that mean I'm the most hateful? That I do lots of dealings with China? And that I'm gonna build a super wall? And also, my best friend is the white ghost.
Not going there.
KKK reference. What? Donald Trump? Huh?
Pretty much.
If he's elected president, our show is screwed. He's going to see this and be like, no, I don't like it. They're off the air.
Build a wall around it.
Build a wall around there. I'm going to build a wall around the internet.
Do you have to swap and rotate, or can you just rotate?
What?
What?
That's a swap. So you don't have to rotate them. You don't have to rotate them. But you may choose to.
I was wondering if I could swap and rotate. Or swap and choose.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to swap these two, right?
Yeah, you do have to swap. So essentially, if you like played that right here, you could swap this one and that one, and you could rotate this one in such a way that it
touches yours.
Yeah. Or you don't have to necessarily swap that one. You could take another one and make them switch places. Like, you could swap these two and rotate them.
But he's also allowed to swap tokens too, right?
Yes, he could instead choose to swap two tokens. Yep. There is a triple ghost.
Yeah, I think I see which one he wants. This would add to your line over here.
Yep.
I was actually thinking about
flinching
with that one.
I know.
My turn?
Yep.
I'm gonna go ahead and lock that down.
I need a drop. I need to drop the drawing of people's tiles.
Great.
Yeah. Like, I have the tiles in here that would make you two happy.
I have the tiles in here that would make Ken happy.
They have ghosts of all colors but mine.
Give me them!
Oh,
give me
love this one.
Give me my tiles!
Alright, so... I took my turn.
Slid into the
it's, yeah, it's...
Again?
Yeah.
Yeah, because...
Because I
both,
just placed my house.
We both placed the haunted houses.
Is on a runaway right now. What's that?
With a place token, I could just move a token, right?
No. You have to place a new one.
Okay.
Now, the only way to move a token is with a rotate tile.
Jeez, green.
It also puts you in a good position to block a run. Just saying.
Don't mind me.
Yeah, but it also gives me time to lock some of this stuff up.
Yep.
Let's drop that. I trade you two of mine for two.
If only. You're up.
I'm going to check you with that.
Jesus Christ.
Taste that.
Yep.
That's a fight between me and Green.
Oh. Well, Blue's got a really good run going there.
And then I'll just do that.
God damn it.
Okay.
Yeah, they pretty much locked you.
Do this over here, and so I can replace one tile with one from my hand. I'm gonna go ahead and take this one and do that.
I feel like being nice to you and helping you start a new run. I'll be nice to help you start a new run if you want to.
keep trying to close green off, but he just keeps making more openings.
Like, I have a tile that could help close green off, but I kind of want to be greedy with it.
Good lord.
Right?
I have this going on right here.
Ooh, I like this one. I'm doing this. That there, swapping these two.
Yep. Yep.
Oh, God.
So he just opened up that block. Yep. That's how you do it.
That's all I can really do, because I got nothing.
Wait, your turn, sorry.
Yeah.
Guess that wouldn't. Well, wouldn't this one block that run?
It doesn't block the run.
Oh,
it just gives him a minus three.
Yeah.
I shall play this one. Use this. There.
Ouch.
You know, I had a really good play for me next turn. You caused this on yourself.
Yeah, I'm just trying to think of a good spot for this one. I think I will go right here.
Fuck yeah!
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
yeah, that does it.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You did that.
Wish I could get these special tiles.
Although, as much as I appreciate the help, I may have something better for myself planned. But thank you anyway. So I believe, Francisco, it is your turn.
Yes.
The guy extended arm out to you, extended arm out to me, help get that over here.
That. That's right, I'll just do this.
Okay.
It's about damn time.
Alright, so here's where it comes down to it, and I need to start counting, because am I going to be able to do what I want to do? I think I can.
No, because one of us is going to find some way to block you.
Because I'm going to get one more tile, you're going to get the last tile, and then everyone, including you, gets one more turn. So I think that will be enough. So if I do this, I can take that, place that, and then take that. Ah, shit, that wasn't the wrong one. Too late.
That one returns. That one returns.
Too late.
You got one more turn.
Yep. I fucked up. I admit it. Because what I had meant to do was place that one, take this one, replace it, and then on my next turn, play that one out and swap.
Oh, that
would have been good.
Yeah, for the one that I took.
Nice. Okay. Is that the one you needed?
So this is the last turn, right?
Last
so
round
this
of
is
turns.
The last tile.
This
you
is
can
your
place.
Last tile.
I don't need any of these.
Oh.
Well, I think the only. Well, we'll see. Actually.
Like, if any of you guys have any place tiles, now would be the time to play them.
Which color are you?
Who, me?
Yeah.
Blue.
He's blue.
Blue.
Okay.
Yeah. It's really the best I got.
Now I have to think this through. Here. I'm trying to decide which one is going to go.
You can help yourself or hurt someone else.
You know, place the real commit, place the tombstone right here, you block a good chunk of his stuff.
So or if you play Zaire, you could pretty much cut his points in half.
Also true.
Dang it.
I think I can fight with him.
Thank you for doing that. Because I'm going to do this.
Oh, wow.
And this is how we do it. Hey. Do it. Oh, that's fine. Oh. You weren't going to give me those last 2 points?
Hell no.
Alright. So, I'm certain that this is my largest section.
So
because that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, there's way more than that.
Alright, so count yours up first.
So, this blocks the run there. So, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29.
We didn't even really bother with it.
Nope.
In the beginning you did.
Yeah. Until count yours up. I don't think
so. Lorenzo has 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 26,
oh, wow.
30, 31, 32.
Nice.
Nice.
Yeah, right, he got three meddling kids.
True.
That's 9 points right there.
Yours?
So remember 32.
Negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Don't count those.
That,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, minus 6, so 14. 4? 4? Well, I didn't even count
he doesn't get the points for those, so it's
yeah.
just minus 6.
So it's 14.
So 14.
Oh, okay. Because I thought he doesn't get the ghost point, and it's minus 2 more from that.
No, it's don't get
it's
the
minus
ghost
three.
Points, then minus 3.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I got 14 points.
And so here we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
points over there.
Plus 3 is 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24.
Yeah, because you took the big one
yeah.
I had over there.
So at 32 points, Lorenzo wins. Second place, me with 29. Third place, Daniel with 24. And finally last, because you had a really good run. And had they not screwed you over at that last play, you would have definitely run away with it.
Yeah,
I couldn't pick up any more special tiles either,
yeah.
So.
I was holding those for the longest time.
I had one rotate, and I was like, I could play this and rotate something to help get me, like, 1 point plus whatever. Or I could play this swap and boom. So.
Yeah, if I had that, I probably would have moved that.
Yeah.
There.
By way of a butt ton of meddling kids, you win. So yeah, that's Graveyard's Ghosts and Haunted
Houses. I did get away with it, thanks to meddling kids.
Yeah. You did get away with it, thanks to those meddling kids. So yeah, that was Graveyard's Ghosts and Haunted Houses. What'd you guys like about the game?
That I just demolished you guys.
The art is awesome.
The art's nice. It's a little more colorful.
Yep. Mm-hmm. It's a nifty tile laying game, you know? Whereas, like you said, with games like Carcassonne, you have to try and think in terms of, I have to play things that match.
Yeah.
In this one, you don't. Mm-hmm. What didn't you like about the game?
A lot of time, it's mainly just what's best here for me, and you're playing by your hand. You can interact some, but not.
There is some of those screw your buddy over moments, but yeah, it's, you know. But I think that's kind of all tile laying games. Carcassonne has the same problem with it being multiplayer solitaire, essentially, where, you know, the entire game I'm playing up here. No one else really affects me all that much because, as you saw. Right at the end, we thought I was going to finish with maybe 15, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And right at the end there, jumped 14 points. So, they don't all fit on one side. So, yeah.
Almost got it all there.
But that's not a huge negative against it, because it's something that all tiling games suffer
from. One thing I do like about this, though, I'm going to say that for him right away, that the ghosts are all different, or look different.
Yeah. So that even if you're colorblind, you can tell which ones are yours. What was your favorite moment of the game? Mine was that swap right at the last minute where everyone was like, oh, that's cool, you got some... What happened?
I think just kind of blocking that last, because if I hadn't put that thing down, that he would have been giving Lynch a run for his money, because that was a nice run right there.
Well, yeah. Then again, even with, like, if he had that run there, I think he had two or three paranoia investigators if he had continued on with the other part of the run.
Yeah.
Like, kept the money
on it. He had negative six, but there was probably a good 10 that got cut off from
there,
it.
There were two tombstones on there as well.
Yeah. The one tombstone didn't harm you all that much.
Yeah, because it just
you had rotated
tile
around it, but, The other tombstone had cut you off from like a good 10 points, which definitely would have turned the tide there.
So it's either block you from winning or block him from winning. There was
because
if I blocked him, yeah. I may have blocked maybe one or two of those metal kids.
But as we saw,
but he went
if that tombstone had been put in that one space on Lorenzo's area, he would have only had another 10 points. That would have really only netted him a bonus. Well, it would have put you at 24.
Yeah.
Because your final score was 14. Yeah. So 24, you would have tied.
Yeah,
had I not screwed you
over. But the
thing
is, the way Lorenzo had his meddling kids, he had ways around a tombstone.
Yeah.
Because he had the two meddling kids on like one area where there was six touching it.
There were actually three tombstones there.
Yeah.
There got, yeah. But like, it wasn't until... Like, my favorite part, though, was... Just kind of like that chase.
Yeah.
Like, during the mid-games, like, he kept trying to block me off, but I was
and
able to
every
find
time,
ways
yeah. Every time we think we've blocked you, you found another opening.
Yeah, it wasn't until, like, the last couple rounds when you guys got, like, five token lane things, and like, mm-hmm. Okay.
Like, you
I
know,
got nothing left.
For a second there, I thought we had blocked off Trevor. Swap.
Mm-hmm. I'm sneaky. Also, I played one token the entire game. And it was a meddling kid on myself.
I played two. I had a meddling kid and I had that graveyard.
Mm-hmm. I played all of my token.
Yeah, you had all the token placements.
Yeah.
It was crazy.
Come on.
And would you recommend this game?
Yes.
Sure.
Yeah.
I think this would go down well with the younger audience as well.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
definitely
simple,
in all ages.
Quick.
Great
this
family
the,
game.
This
yeah.
is the second in the Drawn and Quartered line. The first being Pirates, Ninjas, and Robots, Zombies, which we played last season. There is a next one coming up that is, I believe, your Archaeologists.
Nice.
I don't know if that's been announced yet. It was kind of spoiled to me by the designer. So,
uh-oh.
Forget I said anything. I don't know if they're...
Bleep that
anyway,
section out.
Yeah.
No.
We'll cut that. And they never do. It's always left in.
Mm.
Would you buy this game?
I not for me personally.
I think it's like $20. It's cheap.
It's $19.99,
yeah.
Not for me personally, but I know people who have family would like it.
Yeah.
So I would recommend it for sure.
See, it's a tile placement game that I like. Because Carcassonne has its strengths and weaknesses, but, I mean, essentially there's not a lot of strategy in it, because you only have that one tile on your turn. And it's, well,
yeah.
I have to put this
honestly,
off one of
to
these
me,
areas.
Carcassonne has a little bit more strategic value, just because it also deals with your how you're going to place your meeples.
Yeah.
But are
you going
to put them in a house, or are you going to put them on the road, and stuff like that? So, to me...
I think that's where the tokens come into play here.
Yeah, but the only way you can place that token is if you have a certain
token
yeah.
placement one.
Yeah.
Which,
yeah.
if you're getting all the token placement tiles...
I don't get the placement tile.
And you get 9 bonus points for meddling kids.
And one of the meddling kids was his.
You realize...
Yeah,
no,
it
realize,
was mine. And
yeah,
he did
swap
it with my own
yeah.
graveyard.
And you realize that had you not had that 9 bonus points, you only won by 3 points. You and I would have tied had you not gotten that meddling kid.
No, because he swapped it with
one.
He swapped it with a tombstone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That would have cut his points in half.
Yeah,
because
it would have blocked off
yeah.
half of them.
So
that actually... So
you would have won.
That not only
that
cinched
swap.
You the victory, but those meddling kids was just enough to push you into the
yeah.
lead. So, yeah, that was Graveyards, Ghosts, and Haunted Houses.
Yeah.
If you are joining us from our episode of Unbiased Unboxing, thank you. If you are not and don't know what that is, there's a link in the diddly-doo down there. We will show you a little more up close, the components, teach you how to play, all that fun stuff. So if you haven't seen it, go watch it now. And until next week, thanks for watching. So there you have it. That was Graveyards, Ghosts, and Haunted Houses. You got to hear what our players liked and maybe didn't like. And while I guarantee that your playthrough may not play out exactly like this one, at least you saw the game well played. Until next week, I'm Trevor. Thanks for watching.